The soup in this place. LAPD, who owns this factory, ma'am?
Mr. Parnell. Howard Parnell. I'll let him know you're here. Please, take a seat.
If you don't mind, we'll come with you.
If you must.
You just wanted a follower, didn't you? You sly dog. I must apologize for my partner's roving eye. He hates saying goodbye, but he loves watching them leave.
Give it a rest, Roy.
If you could show these men in to see Mr. Parnell, Doris. They're from the LAPD.
Follow me, gentlemen.
What is going on?
LAPD. Sit tight, fatso. You could be in very serious trouble.
There's no reason to be rude. Take a seat, gentlemen. I'm sure we can sort this all out.
Maybe you can explain why we found $5 bags of marijuana in sealed Parnell soup cans.
That's an outrageous allegation.
How do you explain it, chubby? We found at least 30 cans, all sealed up tight with your label on them.
Can I get a list of your employees?
Of course. We have nothing to hide. Doris, can you bring me in the current employee listing?
Here it is, Mr. Parnell.
On the desk, please.
Any name on that list that rings a bell?
This is familiar. 1452 North Las Palmas. A Jorge Garcia Cruz. The factory sealed cans we found suggest a very professional operation, Mr. Parnell. We're looking for an inside man.
I know nothing about this. I want this stopped as much as you do.
Tell me what I want to know, Parnell, or I will have half the LAPD down here tearing this place apart. You're hiding something.
Am I right in thinking you would not want to pursue misdemeanors outside your drug case?
Depending on what you call a misdemeanor, we might be prepared to turn a blind eye.
The truth is, I employ a lot of illegals. No one wants to do menial work anymore. Most of my factory staff are wetbacks. The local blacks and Chicanos all want jobs in aircraft factories.
Presumably because the pay is a lot better. How are your sales, Mr. Parnell?
Just fine and dandy, son. We're entering a new era of prosperity. I hope you're both big soup eaters.
Mr. Parnell, do you know what kind of trouble you're in? Come clean with us.
Okay, so things are a little flat. We're deciding whether to lower production. It's taken a while to adjust to not having any military contracts. You know, we sold Uncle Sam 5 million cans of minestrone.
Ever heard of Juan Garcia Cruz?
Not that I know of.
He has a brother employed here. You know him?
We employ large numbers of Mexicans. I'm not familiar with them all.
That's funny, Parnell. He has the same address as his brother Juan, who we shot dead less than an hour ago. You better give me something.
Look, I'm not involved in this. I'm getting enough grief from Washington. There's an investigation going on into profiteering, like a guy shouldn't be able to turn a buck while the war is on.
I'm sure thousands of dead Marines sleep soundly knowing that you did okay. Tell us about Jorge Garcia Cruz.
Jorge? I had no idea of his last name. His team does daily maintenance on the conveyor belts and cookers.
So he's here now?
No, maintenance is at night. Night shift finishes around midnight. He would usually come in around 9 p.m. and have everything ready for the morning shift at 6.
We'd like to take a look around the factory floor, Mr. Parnell.
I hope we won't have to shut down the line.
No, nothing like that.
Thank you. I'm grateful for that. I'll show you around myself.
I hate seeing how things are made. This is gonna be like that time I went to the slaughterhouse and couldn't eat steak for a week.
This is where the produce comes in. We peel and sort all of the vegetables and add them to the line in regular quantities.
Fascinating.
Why don't you keep quiet? I might learn something.
Oh, good God. This really is turning into some nightmare school trip flashback.
This is the hopper, which boils and purees the vegetables. The other hopper is for the pasta. This way, please.
You're loving this, aren't you, Phelps?
The soup is ladled automatically into cans. Next stage is labeling.
I'd like to see the packing and dispatch area, if you don't mind.
Sure. It's over here. Follow me. This is one of our dispatchers. Sergio, right?
Yes, sir.
These men are from the LAPD. Sergio here records our outgoing deliveries. They all go in the book. Just there, on the desk.
We're looking for repeat business in large amounts, Cole.
What's going on, Parnell? There's enough soup going to this place every day to feed a company of Marines.
What are you talking about?
Can I have a look at that coin?
Sure, why not?
Silver dollar, right?
Yeah, that's right.
The markings on it say it's been taken out of circulation.
Maybe. I'm not trying to buy anything with it. I like it. It brings me luck.
Do you have access to the canning area?
I do. But I keep to my station. Loading and unloading. Don't care much for soup.
Sergio, if you don't give me something, I'm gonna go to Immigration Services and have you deported.
I get a shipment once every 2 weeks. Ernesto does the driving. I don't know his full name. It's delivered here at night, or he gets it canned up. From here, it gets sent all over the country.
What do you know about the 20th century market?
Nada. I get the orders from upstairs. I send the goods where I'm told.
And you don't know Juan Garcia Cruz?
No, not me.
You're a liar, Sergio. You're in it, and I'm gonna break you for it.
You're loco, Blanca. I got nothing to do with Juan Garcia.
We found a matching silver dollar on Juan Garcia. What are the odds of that, Sergio?
Juan and Jorge are brothers. They're cousins. They work for some evil gabacho. The guy is an aberration. He gives out the silver dollars. Jorge gets me a list of deliveries every morning. 20th century is always on.
You keep your mouth shut for today and I'll take you in. Do we have a deal?
Do I have a choice?
Is that a serious question? That's it for now, Sergio. If we need to speak to you again, we'll put in a call to Mr. Parnell.
If you have to, I guess.
We will be in touch, Mr. Parnell. It is imperative that things appear as normal here. Keep an eye on Sergio in case he gets tempted to blow the whistle.
Thanks. I'll do that. You're going to overlook my little immigration problem, aren't you?
Cheer up, Fatso. We're gonna let you go on squeezing these poor saps a little while longer. Well, until some commie union types infiltrate this place. I am glad to be out of that place. Never knew fresh vegetables could smell so bad.
Have you been in Vice, Roy?
More years than I want to own up to, Phelps.
You have any idea who Rojas was talking about?
The gringo who runs the operation? Could be anybody. You don't expect those morons to be running the show, do you? If you ask Rojas how much a silver dollar was worth, he'd probably say 50 cents.
But it's about all over for Matty Ostrapone. Next, we have Tony Marino and Harold Torrance. Same class, same vim and vigor. The youngster was gay.
Any available unit, the 44 suspects, we take it into custody as Sunset and Ibar. Unit to handle code 2 identified.
KZI is a member of the American Century Broadcasting Network.
Sit tight. Let's take a look at what's going on.
Either these customers are serious soup lovers, or I think we found our middleman.
Car 11 King to KGPL.
Car 11 King, go ahead.
I'm requesting assistance in a B-wagon at 20th Century Markets, 1558 North Highland. Numerous narcotic suspects. Code 2 only, no sirens.
11K, roger.
Okay. Cavalry should be here any minute.
LAPD, nobody move!
I'll take my chances.
Whatever you're carrying, hand it over. I'd say he's got about half a can left. I guess that makes me a pessimist.
You can't take me in.
Take you in? Be glad he didn't shoot you. I wouldn't have chased you. If it was up to me, you'd be talking out of a hole in the back of your head.
I want information.
Señor, I would like to help you, but I got a family in Mexico I have to provide for, and my compadres are very unreasonable.
Your compadres? Turn out your pockets. I need Ray to run down these silver dollars.
Why can't we get any closer?
I need to make a deal. I need guarantees.
You have identification? Sanchez Erto, Mexican, Tijuana address. Here's the deal, Erto. You give me information, and I won't give you to immigration. Give me EJ, the driver bringing in the shipments, or I'll make you for it.
I run the shop. That's all I do.
Tell me the goddamn truth. You are in this with the others.
I told you I know them. I told you my family's at risk. What makes me part of their gang?
You have a silver dollar, Erto, just like Juan. I'm sure Ernesto and the rest have them as well.
The silver dollars are his mark.
Whose? Give me a name.
None of us are allowed to see him. His creatures carry his orders to us. If I gave you his name, I would be buried alongside my wife and children.
If you don't give us something, you will rot in jail while your family starves on the street.
Ernesto Juarez, tonight at 1 a.m. He's bringing the truck into the soup factory. Please help me, sir. Ernesto can be very cruel.
Tell me about the soup cans.
The soup is very popular, as you can see.
The real funny, wise guy. You want to try saying that again with no teeth?
I get a delivery at 7:30 every other day from the factory. Jorge organizes everything.
We know about Jorge and Juan. Juan is dead. Tell us how you know the Cruz boys.
Ernesto put together this thing. He brought in Juan, Juan brought in Jorge.
Continue.
I was already here. Ernesto knows I'm illegal, so he threatened to report me if I didn't help. And the money is good. The gringos and the gringas, they love the reefer. And I didn't want to have to leave and start again in San Francisco.
You're breaking my heart.
You're under arrest, Erto. I'll speak to the DA and see if he will agree to not seize your assets or deport you. That's the best I can do. Freddy said they were moving 50 pounds a week. That's a lot of soup cans.
I think this is an interstate operation. Moving dope around the country to selected grasshoppers. Local weed gets distributed in the usual way, through Pachuco street punks.
Someone must know something about this drug baron character.
Here they come. Let him unload the goods first.
Now?
Let's get him. All right, move. Move! Let's go! Everyone into position.
Got your back. LAPD, put your hands where we can see them. Throw out the guns.
Cole Phelps, get in there.
can hold out.
That's the last of them, Cole. Detectives, found something here you probably want to see.
Tijuana address. We should see what the federales have on it. $1 per dead man. Doesn't seem like much for a human life.
I think we found our stash, Cole. Take a look in these boxes.
At the very minimum, another 50 pounds.
Detectives, I think we got the guy. Does the name Cruz mean something to you?
It certainly does. $1,000 here. Yet another silver dollar.
Phelps, Earl. Looks like quite a bloodbath. What was this all about?
Drugs and money. What else? Speaking of money, where did that roll go?
I picked it up for safekeeping. The department owes me 50.
Ray, I have another 2 coins for you.
Great. I've got something to show you. It's all set up on the table over here. There. Take a look at these coins you've been collecting.
There are letters cut into each coin, along with not legal tender.
Those are Morgan silver dollars from the 20s. They were removed from circulation and sent for disposal. A number of smelters around the country had the contract. Look at them together. Can you work out what it says?
Thank you. The first coin, M-A-S. The second, A-N-G. The third, K-A-Y. The fourth, M-E-T. The fifth, A-L-S. Masanke Metals.
A metal foundry. Would you like the address?
Would I ever.
1034 Vine Street, Hollywood. We'll finish up here. It's already been a long night, Phelps. See if you can talk them into giving themselves up.
Variety shows. This is KTI Radio.
I hope that big wad of cash doesn't weigh you down.
Get your priorities straight, Phelps. We're close to bringing in one of the biggest dope cases of the year, and you're worrying about unsubstantial evidence? Need another way in.
Christ!
Back door, Roy.
caught nothing but garbage all night.
Hey, throw out the guns.
Sanders.
You know this guy?
I should have known.
Of course I know Roy. Roy and I have had an arrangement for many years.
You're under arrest.
Am I?
We have a mountain of prima facie evidence, as well as the testimony.
You'd be surprised how things have a habit of sorting themselves out. Evidence disappearing. Witnesses that can't be found. Policemen that forget. The impossible becomes probable when you have a client list like mine.
Shut your mouth! Turn around and put your hands behind your back.
Working vice can be a thankless task, Phelps. But on behalf of the brass and the moms and dads and the concerned citizens, I'd like to commend you and your partner for smashing this dope ring. Reefer is almost as big a threat to the children of this city as communism.
What about Sanders, Lieutenant?
Leave Sanders to me, Phelps. The chief will be looking after that one personally.
He will be brought to trial.
Phelps, we are celebrating your success. Don't push your luck. Sanders is no longer your problem.
Your platoon is what remains of recon. I'm folding you into the 22nd. You'll be going up that damned hill tonight.
We're intelligence gathering, sir.
I don't need intelligence, son. I need men who can hold rifles and kill Japs. Tonight, you're a rifle company. We've got cooks, mechanics, and stretcher bearers all going into the line. We aim to break them tonight, Lieutenant.
Good to see you, Hank.
You too, Cole. How's your war?
Not quite what I expected.
As long as I live, I will never get over that sound.
Hey, who's that medic?
He'll be killed going out there.
It's Sheldon, the guy from the Asakawa Bridge. That guy's got no fear.
He didn't make it.
I didn't go out there to save him.
What are you saying, man?
I went out there to put him out of his misery, to ease his pain. Do you have a problem with that?
Murder, Corman.
That's war, Lieutenant. Smell the stench. Feel the whore's breath on your neck.
You need help, man.
Call for midnight, Lieutenant, when you're up on that hill. I've been up there 3 times already. The circles of hell have nothing on Sugarloaf Hill.
Get this madman out of my sight!
Like the fight game, Phelps?
I did a little boxing in the Marines. I found it a pretty humbling experience.
Fix your sandwich, buddy. Corned beef and egg salad, 12 cents. Bologna and ham and cheese, 10.
It's strictly a mug's game. You'll like this fight, though. A plucky limey's about to take a beating from an up-and-coming Negro.
You sound pretty sure about the result.
I ought to be. I got 50 bucks on the black kid. Let's get a ringside seat. Son of a bitch Hammond made a run for his dressing room. Let's find out what's going on.
God damn you, Albert! You get out here right now!
Step back! LAPD! What's going on?
That son of a bitch Hammond has jammed the door.
And who are you?
Carlo Arcaro. I'm his manager.
I'm his trainer.
Interesting attitude to have towards a victorious athlete.
Victorious? We had an arrangement. We had a goddamn arrangement!
That limey bastard was paid to take a nap. He reneged.
And you were out of pocket?
Damn right. Me and a couple hundred other people.
Stand aside.
He squeezed out the window. I'll put an APB out on him.
Why would we do that? He won the fight fair and square.
To prevent him from getting clipped. He was paid to flop. There was big money riding on this.
So are we here because you lost money or because we're investigating a prize fighting racket?
Very funny. Look around and see what you can find. Which is Hammond's locker?
Over by the pinboard, second from the end.
There's a phone number we can run by R&I. Plus a bunch of names and odds. You're not the only one who likes a flutter, Roy.
Troubled.
I'm in a jam, Doctor.
Can I help, Courtney? Is it money?
No, doctor. That's okay. Do I have your professional confidence?
Whatever you say, we'll never leave this room.
I talked some of the guys in my old unit into doing something, and it's gone wrong. I guess I did it for the wrong reasons, for short-term gain. We came home from China on the Cool Ridge.
The morphine robbery.
That was us. I thought I could get the guys a fair share. Some sort of benefit for the sacrifices that they made in the war. Those guys deserve it, Doctor.
Oh, I'm sure they do, Courtney. But the deserving aren't always rewarded.
Tell me about it, Doc. We shifted our stuff onto this mob-connected guy, and it's been turning up all over town. It wasn't meant to be like this.
The presumption was rather naive, Courtney.
I know that now, Doctor. But people are dying. Hmm.
Might I venture a few questions?
Sure.
Do your underworld contacts have all the morphine?
No, they don't. We doled it out, hoping we could control it.
Are they pressing you for further allocation?
That's the polite way of putting it, Doctor.
I may be able to help you, Courtney.
Thanks, Doc. It helps just to talk about it.
I mean, I have a solution that will help you financially and salve your conscience.
I'm all ears, Doctor.
I will transact to take all the narcotic off your hands. And you can rest assured that it will all be medically administered. I will use the funds that I no longer require for the purchase of medication and invest them in housing developments.
Housing?
The developments in question are housing projects for former servicemen. Your return will come from the sale of the properties, and your investment will benefit those that you care for most. Does this arrangement meet with your approval?
You're a magician, Doctor.
You better find that cocksucker and you bring him to me.
I feel bad too, Mickey. He guaranteed me he would take the flop.
I guarantee that you will be fish food if you don't bring me... Roy, you out of pocket too?
Mickey, seems that way.
Don't worry about it. My boys are out looking for him.
Well, you'd better call them off. This is a police matter now. If anything happens to Hammond, I'll testify that you made threats against him.
Who's the Greyhound? He's a frisky one, isn't he?
Cole Phelps? Mickey Cohen.
I know who he is, Roy. I met his brother-in-law.
I think you had the mixture pretty scared back there.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address for the following phone number, AL345.
The address for the phone number is the Hotel El Mar, 6294 Leland Way, Hollywood.
Thank you.
You know the place?
Flophouse. Quarter a night, no questions asked.
Hello?
Washington.
You seem to have a pretty cozy relationship with Cohen and Stampinato.
Do I note a hint of reprimand in your tone, Detective? Talking to gangsters comes with the turf. You should try out Mickey's place. He's got a haberdasher's up on Sunset. See if he can get you out of those old man's clothes that you slink around in.
It's a front for his illegal activities.
It is that, but he does carry some very sharp suits.
If it's okay with you, I'll stick with Brooks Brothers.
What do you want?
LAPD. We're making inquiries into the whereabouts of an Albert Hammond.
No one here by that name.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure. This isn't the sort of place where people use their real names. Take a look at the register if you don't believe me.
Son, you're a couple of shingles short of a full roof.
It's a cop from the UK.
Okay, so look for prominent Tommies. That should narrow it down.
Hey! There's such a thing as soap, you know.
Winston Churchill. A very patriotic Englishman is staying in room 207.
The old bulldog. Even at a flop house, Adley can't get out from his shadow.
Am I missing something here?
Door's unlocked. Looks like he's had a broad up here.
He must be heading home. You know, I hope he makes it.
That crooked son of a bitch, no chance.
Instaheat. Adrian Black's product of choice. Seems like a lifetime ago.
Candy has expensive taste. Albert has his work cut out for him.
Who's Candy?
Candy Edwards, the lady who filled out this coupon.
All right, let's go after his girl. See if that gets us any closer.
Does Albert have somebody special? I didn't see anyone in his corner at the fight. I guess a fighter has plenty of time on his hands between bouts. Still warm. Looks like Albert has been doing some homework. 11 grand would be a nice little nest egg.
Couple of shingles short of a full roof. Hey, there's such a thing as soap, you know. Am I missing something here?
I think his name is Phelps. He brought in the case.
Hammond is over the hill. He's a punching bag for the up-and-comers. He should know his goddamn place.
I think he knows. I think he worked out the place isn't L.A.
He's punchy. His brain's going to mush. Winston Churchill? Give me a break.
Churchill is a fighter, Roy. Hammond didn't just scribble down the first name he could think of.
So, you boxed in the Marines?
We all did. Standard training.
I can't imagine you ever played dirty.
The only prize for taking a fall was 1,000 push-ups.
But when I think of you, another shower storm into each life, some rain must fall.
The American Century Broadcasting Company salutes our veterans.
We need to know which room is Candy's.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
LAPD, ma'am. We're looking for Candy Edwards.
Apartment 7. You take the outside stairs by the parking lot and turn left at the top. You friends of the Italian guy?
Italian guy?
Yeah. Sleazy type. Gave his name as Carlo. I didn't like the look of him, but Candy has some funny friends.
Thanks.
This Candy broad must be as sweet as she sounds. All these gentlemen callers.
Being decisive. Well... Give it up.
Sounds like we're missing all the fun. Get in there, Phelps.
You know where he's hiding. Now tell me where he is before I cut you.
I told you, I haven't seen him.
Like hitting women. This isn't going to end well for you, friend. Out cold, but breathing. Give her a minute and take a look around.
Carlo here seems to have the same friends as Hammond. What are the odds on them all being bookmakers? Nasty weapon.
All the Italians carry them. A real man uses his fists or a gun.
She's leaving town. Single ticket, one way. I guess there isn't a lot for Albert in Ohio. Scania sails from New York. Take a seat, Miss Edwards. We have some questions for you to answer.
Look, I haven't done anything wrong.
Ever? I find that pretty hard to believe.
Can you answer some questions now, Miss Edwards?
Sure, I've had worse. I'll shake it off.
We're trying to track down Albert Hammond. We have reason to believe he might be in danger. You know where he is?
No, I don't. I'm over Albert. I haven't seen him.
You're lying, Candy. You were in his hotel room. He came back after the fight and you weren't there. What happened?
You can't prove that I was in the room.
How do you think we found you, Candy? You wrote your name and address on a coupon.
Look, Albert was supposed to take a fall. We were all supposed to make a little money out of it. But Albert got too goddamn stubborn. Said his pride was all he had left. So I told him, shove it. Let's see his pride keep him warm at night.
So you walked out before the fight?
Yes, I did. What's the problem? I didn't take anything.
Do the names Harry, Mervin, or Ray mean anything to you?
Could be anybody. How the hell would I know?
They're bookmakers, aren't they? Tell me the truth.
How the hell would I know?
Albert wrote his winnings down on a notepad in the hotel room. We found the odds in his locker. Who has the betting slips?
That son of a bitch, Albert. Everyone thought he was dumb, including me. But he beat them all.
You're leaving town, Miss Edwards?
Yes, I'm going straight home.
Albert is going home by boat as soon as he collects his winnings. I know you're going to meet him.
Albert is going to collect nothing. He'll be lucky if he can get out of town in one piece.
How will you fare any better? They already believe you're in on it.
Hell, I know you're in on it.
You can think what you want, Buster. I'll take my chances. I got a few errands to run, and then I say adios to this dump.
Do you want to press charges against Arcaro?
Just get him out of here. That's all I want.
Get out, Carlo, you hump. And get rid of that pig sticker.
You ever pull that thing on me, I'll shoot you like a dog.
That bitch knows where Hammond is. She knows where my money's gone.
My money too, tough guy.
I'll handle this.
Good luck, Miss Edwards.
I hope things work out for you.
Thank you. It's very kind of you to say so.
Bad people are looking to hurt Candy, and yet she's not heading straight for the train station? I smell a payoff. I say stake her out. See where she goes. Tail this broad. Don't let her get away, but don't get spotted. I'll bring up the car behind you.